gon' be. Fucking with a nigga like me. D to the M to the X. Last I heard.
Alright, so this video is to show you how to do secondary chameleon. See it a lot on Skylines because of the racing stripes. You can do secondary on those. You'll see it also on Lambos and any of the real high-end cars. So basically, person comes in, you're in the menu, go into vehicle colors, and you do the chameleon. Find whatever chameleon that they want. We'll just say a red and green flip for this one, just as an example here. Once you do that, you back out, go back into primary, and then select normal. And then you can select the mats, the finish, and everything on it. So there's the secondary chameleon. You see it's still the green-red flip there. We have the base coat, which everybody saw before I put it on there, which was pink. You can even go in to pearlescence and add different pearlescence on. As you can see, it changes the colors around a little bit. So if you throw like lava red, you can see it a little bit closer there. It's hard because it's matte. If we go back in to metallic, go to it. Darker pearlescent. Let's do like one. Actually, now I'm blue. So you can do quite a bit. But just to show everybody once more, hit no close. So here's the standard color. Jump into it. I'll go a little bit slower. Vehicle colors. Chameleon, find the color you want. We'll do a wine this time. And then jump back into primary and just select normal. Then as you spin the color around, you can see the wine chameleon on the stripes and then the base coat that the car was initially laid over it. Now, anybody that comes in with a car, whether it be a mechanic or anybody else, if we go in and do like open up the menu and back out of it, there is a good chance that the secondary chameleon will drop off. So if you apply this to anybody's car, you have to let them know that up front. Because if they come back into the shop and somebody goes in and looks at something and it drops off, then we have to charge that person to put the chameleon back on. As you see, it's 3,800. Or 38,000 right now. Brain dumb. So if they drop it, so if it dropped off for any reason, we may be able to help them out, especially if they did were not if they did not know prior to. We could sometimes help them out. But as I'm telling everybody in this video, make sure that you tell them up front before you said it and they charge out for it. That if they come back in and make any changes, there's a good possibility the city will catch it and drop it off. Because this is technically a city glitch. And when the city removes the secondary, it's the city catching that glitch and removing automatically. It's a city failsafe. So it's fine to have it on the car, but they just have to know that it can drop off if we make any changes to the car in the future. And at that point, they will have to have be charged to have it put back on. So hopefully this video helps everybody. If you have any questions, please reach out. Ask. I'm sure somebody will let you in the shop kind of mess around in the car, see how it works. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Pretty simple. Not everybody knows how to do it. It's not really talked about a whole lot, but everybody sees it. So that's how you do it.